Hey guys, so I love my Technic space station stuff, and one of the things that my stepson and a lot of people that I play games with, they kind of get a bit daunted by is the idea of getting lots of resources up into space, the amount of time it takes to get to that. Once you've done that, you get into space and it's like building all over again. So something that I wanted to do was make a video about potential ways in which you can make your space station self-sufficient, and you can get a lot of resources up here, which is literally just generated resources. And also, as I'm saying this, I've noticed that someone has built that on my space station. So, yeah. Anyway, so the way this space station works, well, the two methods that the space station uses is in here, is in that sort of big dome, is a tree farm, and we've got our over there is just a sort of garden for generating oxygen. And over here we've got a nuclear powered section which uses a laser drill to generate resources, and all of these things here generate more energy than they use. So this is basically free energy. And I'm really getting curious about this because it looks very much like a TARDIS, which is kind of cool. We'll have to have a look at it. Oh, that's awesome. That's fucking awesome. Oh my god. They made it bigger on the inside. This is fucking amazing. And wait a second, wait a second. Is that like a creeping angel I see over there? I'm kind of scared. Here. Ah, those cheap bastards. All they've done is built it in the Nether, haven't they? Still, kind of cool. Oh, well, back to the video. Sorry. That's just random. Okay, that's kind of cool that someone's built that there. Right, okay, so back to the video. So, let's go in here. Right, so this first area here is, this is essentially a tree farm. And what this does is we've got a harvester here and we've got a planter. And these essentially, this is big enough to create enough energy to basically supply everything you need. So everything that you see in here, so this, as if I take off the helmet that the character's wearing here, or my spacesuit helmet, whatever, oxygen mask. As you can see, this is all oxygen sealed in here. And all of this runs off of this tree farm in here. We've also got, the ability to run all the things. And this tree farm also, it generates sludge, which you can use with a sludge boiler to create a ton of resources. So this is just sort of the stuff that I don't really use. But in here, as you can see, you've got clay, lots of dirt, lots of sand, and lots of gravel. Those can be useful to make all sorts of base resources. As you can see, this here is cyan stained clay. Decided to put this over here because I have no idea what this mycelium uses. So yeah. And if we have a look here, as you can see, this has got 10,000 out of, sorry, 10 million out of 10 million RF in there. And I'm going to have to put my space helmet back on because underneath here is not oxygen sealed. Now, something else when you're looking at this is this, to do a tree farm, it needs to be open to space. You need to have no oxygen seal in there. It's something with the oxygen seals that if you try and put down certain objects, it will not allow you to put them down in an area where the oxygen is sealed. And one of those things is that when a sapling turns into a tree, the actual sapling itself doesn't get destroyed. And one of the problems with that is that if you're putting this harvester that just on the base level, is what it senses is the tree block, the actual log block. And because there's a sapling there, it doesn't register anything and it doesn't catch anything. So one of the things you want to remember, even if you don't want to do it in a sealed area, so if you want to do it in a sealed area, is you have to make sure that the actual tree farm itself is hidden. This is a 14 by 14 tree farm, and this generates way, 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 way too many resources that I need. So if we then go down into here and have a look underneath, now this is kind of a massive build. I'm sure you can tell that some of this was done in Creative, because I do love these sort of dome looks. And this was done, I'll put the link under see. It's not Mineconics, there's something else. There's a website you use to generate all this stuff. I can't remember off the top of my head. But you can generate a certain structure and get a layout for it, so it's fantastic. So as you can see here, we've got a single harvester up there. And all of those resources, it's all sealed in. The resources come down to that chest there, and then from that chest they're sorted. And down into here we get the logs and any excess saplings that can't go into there. That has a huge inventory. And up there, I just have the apples going into a deep storage unit. These deep storage units are fantastic if you want to make them. They allow you to store one resources up to huge amount of numbers. So if we look into here, we've got 3,500 saplings, almost 8,000 wood, and 20,000 charcoal in there. And I still can't generate, sort of get through the wood. Even though I've got three redstone furnaces here, and a normal furnace. This normal furnace just uses the saplings to create more charcoal. These redstone furnaces all just take the wood out of there and turn it into charcoal and put it into this deep storage unit. And that supplies all of these steam dynamos over here, which I'm sure you can see. Now, this is, it's probably looks a bit funky. And it's, I do apologize if you get any sort of like, it gets a little bit on your nerves, sort of OCD sort of style, but this basically, essentially what we're doing is we've got this farm. So we've got the tree farm up there. It's being harvested. It's being replanted. Any saplings that are taken from it used to restock the supply up there. Everything else goes into this making coal. This coal is then fed into these 12 steam dynamos up here. And these 12 steam dynamos power that harvester and the harvesters up there and the planter there. And as you can see, it generates way more enough energy. This wasn't a creative cell that was put on here. This was just an empty resonance cell. And as you can see, I think that's 45 million RF there. And we've got another 10 million up there. And I believe that when I charged up the backpack that I'm using, or jetpack that I'm using, that took like quite a lot out of it. And I've also got this sludge that's being fed out here to that sludge boiler. So this is a completely self-sufficient system. You know, it's running all of these oxygen sealers. It could run all of these all day without a problem. You would have to have an area that's quite big. I mean, I think you would want at least a 10 by 10 area to do the tree farm. And one of the most important things is, if you're actually going to seal it in at all, is you have to have a 2-block space around it, and you have to have it high enough for trees to grow. But if you do that, you know, it's lit with these glowstone bricks inside there. This will run perfectly fine, and this will easily provide power. I've just built this one way too big. You know, I sort of built it around this dome. It doesn't need to be that big. It's creating excess resources, you know, to a huge degree. And like I said, you get all these building resources out of it. Another really good thing about this method of doing this is, not only do you get those sort of the dirt and the sandstone, the clay which can be used for things, is if you are comfortable using minium stones, this clay can quite easily be turned into diamonds eventually. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a few stacks of this, and we'll do enough to do 2 stacks of the blocks of clay. And I'm going to cheat a little bit and get myself a minium stone. So minium stone, and we'll just get a workbench as well. On a crafting table, not a workbench. Crafting. There we go. Right, so I wonder if this will be able to display. Nope, I can put that down without a problem. Right, so now if I make all of these into blocks of clay, so we'll just make 64 clay there, and we'll just put, I don't know why I did that, but just put all 4 of these up there. So we'll get out 2 stacks of clay. And now if we use a minium stone, what we can do with this clay is turn it into iron. And that iron can then be turned into gold. and that gold can be turned into a diamond. And as you see, it's really not taken that much off the minium stone. The minium stone for every item you use takes a use of it, and I think you get 1500 uses on it. Other methods by doing it, I mean, technically you could turn wood from this into diamonds, but by the time you've made them into diamonds, you wouldn't get any other uses out of the minium stone. But this using clay to do that, if you've got a setup that's very, very proficient like this, and gives you lots and lots of runoff from that sludge boiler, you could easily use that to make enough diamonds to keep yourself in minium stones and then make iron, gold, or any other item that you needed from it. And just to show you how, you know, sort of even like this huge area with these oxygen cedars, we've got a lot in here. We've got like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, I think we've got 8 in here alone. Is the amount of area you need if you're doing it in like a big chunk of leaves is really not that much. I mean, this basically this floor level of in here, we've got, I think, 7 oxygen cedars in here, and they easily provide enough oxygen for the whole area. This place isn't oxygenated. So that's sort of like a low techy sort of version of where you might want to do self-sufficient power, allow you to create stuff, get some resources, etc., etc. But the other side of this area that I've built is nuclear powered. And what you can actually do is with this nuclear power, you can get pretty much any ore or any valued resource that you need and still provide power for yourself. So the main thing it does, it uses a nuclear reactor. I would recommend looking at the Minecrafters. They've done an amazing tutorial on nuclear reactors, and you learn what sort of stuff can actually make them much more efficient. You know, I've got a 3-level high in here, and it's just filled with this redstone flux, I think it is. Now, it's currently fairly depleted, and it's still giving out almost 5,000 redstone flux per second. Now, this reactor has the whole time only been running off a stack of 64 yellowite that I put in there. So I've got myself a cyanide reprocessor here, which just feeds it straight back inside. This has all been run off of one stack of 64. That's it. There has been no more fuel put in this at all. And if we go and look over here, so we've got our 4 laser drill pre-chargers. And if you look in the drill first, you'll notice that what I've lined up is 6 focus of lime. And lime would increase your chances of getting ores like uranium. So 64 yellowite, which is the equivalent to 32 uranium or 16 nether ore, has produced so far, and it's still going. Let's see, we've got 64 nether uranium there. 64 uranium ore, another 4 uranium ore there. 3 yellowite ore. Is there anything else there? Got any other nether uranium? Not that I can see. So this 64 nether uranium here would be 4 stacks. So that'd be 256 there. This would be 2 stacks, that'd be 128 yellowite we'd get from that. Plus another 8. So we've got 256 plus 128 plus 8 from that, plus another 6 from that yellowite. So just even a quarter of the nether uranium we would have got from this setup would have repowered this reactor, and it's, you know, it's still pumping out energy, and we're still going to get loads of stuff from that. Now, what that could then mean is you could have one reactor that is just, you know, sort of completely focused on getting the uranium, and you could have a system in here of a chest where it's fed in, and maybe, you know, the sort of the feed off is fed into the chest, and it on priority takes in the yellow light or whatever. But that would be more than enough to keep this reactor going. And then you could maybe have a bigger reactor or a same size reactor, and you could run that for something if you wanted to get specific resources. So you could put in, you know, focuses to get more diamond and platinum based things. So shiny ingots are really important if you're using the whole Tekkit pack, really great for the really end game sort of stuff, as well as sort of that, you know, all your ender based stuff as well. You could also use, you know, sort of get all your iron ores, get all your copper ores. You could do that by, you know, sort of making these focuses or foci that allow you to get resources of those colors, and you could easily run 1, 2, 3, maybe even 4 reactors just from one of them that's focused on this line. So hopefully that's a little idea of what you might be able to do to enable yourself to get all the resources you need from a space station and make it self-sufficient, maybe taking down the daunting side of it a little bit. I mean, you know, you wouldn't have to have all of this in here. You wouldn't have to have it enclosed. You could literally, this could just literally be a platform with all that wiring underneath, and it just does this, and it, because it automatically collects it. Only certain things, you know, sort of the occasional one that gets dropped and fly off into space, but it's more than enough to provide you power for that. And just as that nuclear over there is, it's not actually that hard to set that up, you know, with, you could use maybe half of your inventory and easily bring up all you needed to set up a nuclear power situation like that, which gave you everything you needed. Okay, so I hope that's been useful to anyone who's been watching this, maybe didn't know how to sort of get around getting resources in the space station, or maybe sort of found it a daunting task, wanted to build something in the sort of whole space station situation. And the other side of it as well is this is all of this is completely viable for using on one of the normal world, or using on a foreign planet, something like, you know, the moon, or using it on Mars. Is all of this would work. You know, all you have to do is drill down to bedrock for that to work. This just happens to have no space between bedrock, and this can just be built anywhere that you get sun, to be perfectly honest. And if you're providing light for it, it doesn't even need that. It just needs access to the air. Okay, so I hope that's been useful. I hope you've enjoyed the video. One last thing I wanted to do before I go. These deep storage units, if you wanted to build a big project like this, you know, these are fairly big domes that I've built here. It may seem like, once again, that's daunting to get all this up there, but what you could do with these is you could make a deep storage unit and just store the blocks that you're going to use. So for example, to build all of this, I could have just stored, if I was crazy enough to store it all up, loads of cyan stained clay and a load of glass, and then I could have just brought it up in a spaceship with me and just place it down and keep taking out your stacks. Anyway, hope you enjoyed the video. Hope you enjoyed yourself. Hope you enjoyed the silliness with the TARDIS. Have fun, and hopefully you do some amazing builds. Bye.